Thank you so much for watching, and please like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.
Okay.
Did you pull it up into the water? That's not great, but I'm going to use my paper for a little bit more. Okay, sweat it down a little bit.
Take a little break, going back. Now, these are a bit tiring. Again, the old used piece. And you're probably wondering why I haven't done any like spraying the black on to see if I have any high and low spots. This thing is so curved, every little inch of it would be very limited spots that have actually saved me any. I'm just going by feel and touch, sight. guide coat. Couldn't think of the name of it. My brain doesn't work as good as it used to. This maybe I could have. Do it all by hand. For you. Sanding sounds like food. I'm sorry. The thing, at least when hand sanding like this, is you see all the little spots. You catch them now before you put the sealer on. Ah, get a wrinkle in my paper. I change my paper, I'll get a wrinkle on it. If I scratch it. Well, maybe I'll use the edge and go around there. You need to go around the edge, make sure you get that edge. For some reason, when people look at a vehicle, I don't know why, they put a hand under and run on the edge. They used to shoot the metal with fiberglass. Don't want to feel rough. Going to fiberglass wouldn't have helped me. Because they had to be cut down because of the 3-inch section. So it wouldn't have helped. Well, the paper's still working, so I'm going to keep it going. Keep my costs down. I don't want the pennies. I'll give you a total or not when I'm done. I've kept every bill of everything I've purchased. Paint, primer, sandpaper, you name it, I've saved it all. So I have a total. And of course it does include the labor, the time. It does include the truck. The motor, transmission, differential, steering. Well, some of the steering was to replace some of it.
As you've seen through the videos, we did the work 99% of the time. I mean, a few things I couldn't do, like putting the tires on, the rims. In the old days, I might have tried, but I can't do it anymore. Running the paint there, the grips. Take them off the coarser stuff. One thing about this, a G2 featherlite, you can tell where you sand it in half, that's for sure. Rub your hand along there, as soon as you hit a spot, it drags, so you know that it's still not sanded enough. Well, that's number two. Okay, let's get ready for the next one. Not a fresh piece of 400. I'm going to keep going with the wet sanding. Feels like it's going to rain, but... What do you think, Rooster? Think standing on that rock makes you look big? Hey? No! Hey? You want to help me? Didn't think you were. And you keep an eye open for those bugs, though, eh? Okay? Eh? If you would help me sand, I'd rather just watch. Call the garden hose. Okay, so this is number 1, 2, 3, piece number 4. I got 6 pieces to do today. I'd like to get done if I could. we'll see how we make out. I'm gonna start down this corner. It up to start. Make it wet so it keeps it clean. Don't need that grit, just roll them back and forth. That's where the sun's coming out. It's calling for rain. I won't take any chances of paint today anyway. It's very, very humid. So I'm going to try to get all these ready for tomorrow. Get a big paint today, but we'll see. That's six pieces, a couple little pieces too. Coat of primer, three or four coats of paint, three or four coats of clear. That's a lot of coats. I don't know. We'll see. Not sure how I'm going to even paint these yet. It'll be hard to paint. Don't think I can hang them up. We'll see. Rinse it down, see how it looks. Next piece.